Hello and welcome to this Pixotope tutorial. In this video I'm going to talk about the post-process handler and how that works together with post-process volumes. So I have an empty scene open, only containing the Pixotope essential actors, and you can see the post-process handler is one of those actors. The post-process handler needs to be in the scene at all times. You can never delete or disable this actor. The post-process handler is actually a modified version of the post-process volume that comes with native Unreal. So you can see all the different settings that this actor contains. It doesn't contain something that the post-process volume doesn't have. But this is set up to drive the rendering pipeline, and it also communicates directly with the director. So under the production tab, we have the different composites and effects and the color grading. So if I now select my post-process handler and I search for white balance, and I open director again under the color grading, if I now under 3D graphics and I enable my white balance, you can see it enables these two. And this value controls this value. I'm gonna turn this off again. In the post-process handler, you also have if I go all the way down, we have this post-process volume settings. And here you can actually choose to disable this, but you can see what happens if I do this. It breaks the rendering. My video disappears. The same thing happens if I uncheck the infinite extent, the unbound settings. This will also break it will break the entire render pipeline. So it's not possible to use this. The infinite extent is kind of, I can actually show you if I add a regular post-process volume into this. So now I selected the post-process volume, and I have the same menu here. And by default, this is not set to be unbound. So that means that my camera needs to be within this volume in order for the post-process volume to work. If I check this on, then you will still see this kind of this small box, but it doesn't apply anymore. Now this will extend like infinity in all axes. This will cover the entire scene, so it's not possible to like go outside the volume anymore. But for this example, I'll just set this to be bound. So in Pixotope 1.3.1, actually we change the priority of the post-process handler. So if I select the post-process handler and I go search for priority, you can see this is now set to be 1,000, like a really high number. And that because we always want the post-process handler to be above or take control of all other post-process volumes that exist in the scene. So you can see my post-process volume has the default priority of 0. So what this means is that if I select my post-process volume and I search for the white balance again, and I'm going to go to white balance, temperature, and I'm going to just drag this all the way down. If I now move into my the post-process volume, you can actually see the effect of this. But the post-process handler still has a higher priority. So if you enable the white balance in this, it will take, it will override these values. So now I'm going to go back into director again, and I'm going to go to the white balance settings. You can see now this is turned on, and you can see this actually totally discards all the settings that we did in the post-process volume. And that is because the post-process handler has a higher priority value than the post-process volume. If we were to change this change this value if I go to post process handler and I select the priority and I set this to 0. And now my post process volume has a 0 and post process handler is 0. They have the same priority value. What now will happen is that Pixotope will apply the settings to the volume that is being edited last. So if I now go to the white balance again, I'm just gonna go so we can actually see it. I'm gonna turn this all the way down so you can see now this works as intended or as you would expect. If I now go to the post process volume and I change this, now all my changes in the post process handler in director will be discarded. And if I now start moving this again, this will be the one that it that will affect the image. So that's usually the effect that people are having when they're importing projects from native Unreal. They have already set up their post process volume and they have adjusted all the settings the way they like, and but they haven't changed the priority of it. So it's set by default to a priority of 0. So then what happens is when you open this into Pixotope and the post process handler comes along with a higher or the same priority, and then we start modifying this, it will override the settings. So there is a number of ways that you can actually use the post process handler and the post process volumes together. Like, of course, the best thing is to just have one volume. It makes everything easier. It's faster to adjust the look, and you will always have access to everything in Director, and you will not get any like unexpected surprises along the way. So if it's possible to get away with only one post process volumes or the handler, you should take your settings from the post process volume and manually copy over everything to the handler. So like all the values, and if you have used LUT files or post process materials, whatever it is, if it's possible, then put this into the handler. But if you need, say you want to have a virtual camera move, for instance, that you want to go through an area that should have like another grading or more contrast or whatever you need, it is actually possible to place out, and you can like this can be scaled as any other actor. And placed where you want your camera move in this case to be. So then you can go to the post process handler and you can set your priority to 0 as we did earlier, and then we can actually do the post process volume. We can set this to be 1. So, but just be careful when doing this, because this will mean that when the camera is entering this volume, it totally takes control over the post process handler. And also, if I go back to the to my volume settings, where we have the priority, we also have a blend radius, which is kind of is soft. You can see it kind of has a soft fall off when I move into the volume. So this controls the range of how soft the transition will be. If you set this to 0, it will be a really harsh, like you can see it like a snaps. Set this back to the default value. It also has a blend weight, and this controls how much this volume will affect the final look. So if this is set to 1, so it's 100%, if I set this to 0.5, it's 50%. And if I set this to 0, then it will kind of just disable the whole volume. I'll set this back to 0.5. So say that I am changing going back to the white balance again, and I'm gonna go with setting this to something like that green tint. So remember, now the volume has a higher priority than handler. So this will always be overriding the values that you're changing. But it doesn't it doesn't change all the values. It only changes the values that you have enabled, that these one that you have unchecked. So that means that even though this volume has a higher priority than the handler, I can still go into my post-process handler, and I'm accessing this in director just to make it a bit more clear. If I go to the video white balance, I still have access to control the white balance of the video because I have not exposed this value in the post-process volume. So the post-process volume, which has a higher priority, it's overriding only the values that I have exposed, which in this case, that's the white balance for the graphics. So in my post-process handler again, I have now gone to video white balance, and you can see I have the video white balance here as well. So now remember, this has higher priority. If I now go to set this to another temperature, now this will override the post-process handler 100%. Of course, now I have 50% blend, so it will be 50% override, but I'm going to set this back to the default value, which is 1. So now my camera is inside this volume, and if I now go to my post-process handler again, and I try to adjust the white balance for the video, like, now this will not work. So that is kind of the most important thing to be aware of, is the priority settings of the volume and the handler. So if you're setting the priority of the volume higher than the one of the handler, be really careful. Then you should be like, you have to know what you're doing with this. But it is possible to have this control and to get this effect too. Yeah, and you can actually see that the tint is still working, because in our volume, I have not enabled the white balance video tint. So you can see this is working. But as soon as I go into the volume and enable the tint, now this doesn't work anymore. So that is how the post-process volumes works together with the handler. So just remember that you should never delete or disable the post-process handler. It will totally break everything render-wise to. You can also see if I try to disable this. Also, if I try to set the blend weight of the handler, this will also break the render pipeline to. So this should also be set to 1, enabled and unbound. But the priority, you are free to play around with. But this is set to default to 1000, just so it will override all other post-process volumes.